is your name, please?
My name is U.E. Baughman.
What is your name, please?
My name is U.E. Baughman.
What is your name, please?
My name is U.E. Baughman.
Two of these people are imposters. Only one of them is the real U.E. Baughman, and is the only one sworn to tell the truth. And here is our host, Bud Collier.
Thank you and good evening. We're here again with our game of deliberate misrepresentation in which four presumably smart people try to figure out which one of three challengers has sworn to tell the truth. Tell the Truth is brought to you, as you know, by Geritol, America's number one tonic. The high-potency tonic that helps you feel stronger fast. And now let's meet our cross-examiners. What is your name, please?
My name is Polly Bergen.
My name is Ralph Bellamy.
My name is Kitty Carlisle.
And my name is High Gardner.
Now, these three people all claim to be U.E. Baughman. Of course, only one is the real U.E. Baughman. The other two have simply assumed that identity, and they do not have to stick to the truth. Now, panel, in front of you, there is a copy of an affidavit. Will you please listen and follow along as I read it to you? I, U.E. Baughman, live in Arlington, Virginia. I have spent 30 years of my life in the employ of the federal government. I started in December of 1927 as a clerk stenographer. I am now Chief of the United States Secret Service. I swear that the above statement is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Signed, U.E. Baughman. Now on with our game. Three people, as you know, all claim to be U.E. Baughman, Chief of the United States Secret Service. Now remember, only the real U.E. Baughman is required to answer your questions truthfully. You will each question until you hear this signal. And at the end of the questioning period, you'll be asked to register your vote for the one person who, in your opinion, is the real U.E. Baughman. And we will begin this first round tonight with Ralph Bellamy. Ralph?
Well, since the real Mr. Baughman has to tell the truth, let's start with an embarrassing one. Number one, how old are you?
52.
Number two, how old are you?
51.
Number three, how old are you?
49.
Number one, at what age did you start to work for the government?
27.
Number two, how old?
22.
22. Number three, how old?
20.
20. I have to figure this out now.
While you're figuring, Ralph, I'll have to move along. Kitty Carlisle. Kitty?
You lost me in the mathematics, but I'd like to know from number two, what are the difference in the duties between the FBI and the Secret Service?
The Secret Service protects the President of the United States and also investigates counterfeiting violations. The FBI has a number of duties, interstate violations, kidnapping laws, and so forth.
Number three, you deal in smuggling and that sort of thing, don't you?
No, ma'am.
Oh, you don't? I mean, the Secret Service sort of protects people from being smuggled.
No, ma'am.
No. Well, don't they even care? I said it all.
Hi.
Number one, as a member of the Secret Service, can you tell me who is Frank M. Barry?
He's one of our agents who is on leave now in another country, establishing a Secret Service.
Number two, is the U.S. Secret Service permitted to tap wires?
No, sir.
Number three, I'd like to ask this question. Could I be a Secret Service agent?
Mr. Gardner, I don't think any columnist would make a good Secret Service agent.
I didn't mean what I wrote. I meant my height.
I'm afraid you're a little too short.
Polly Bergen.
Number two, if I made a counterfeit bill and I had it on me, could you arrest me right now?
Well, if you made it, I wouldn't arrest you right now, but I would right after the show.
he's a right guy.
Yeah, he sure is.
Number three, is there... Is there anything, as far as counterfeit bills, that makes it more difficult to make them than anything else? The one thing that's difficult to copy in a counterfeit bill?
Why, yes. Well, you want to know what it is?
Yes, sir, please.
Well, generally, it's the engraving, the picture, the toning, shading.
I see. Number three, is there anything difficult about the paper? Is the paper changed from time to time?
No, it's been constant for years.
The same paper.
Ralph?
Number two, when was the Secret Service instituted and by whom?
In 1865.
And that's about it, I'm afraid, panel. It's time already to vote. So without consultation, will you mark your ballot and vote for number one, number two, or number three? May I remind you that the team of challengers will get $250 for every incorrect vote, which means, of course, with a little mathematics, that if they fool the entire panel, they may divide as much as $1,000. All right, panel, have you marked your ballots?
Yep.
No answers I'm getting. Thank you, Ralph. Polly, for whom did you vote? And don't glare at me like that.
I voted for number two.
You have a reason?
No.
Good. Ralph, your vote was for?
Number one. He's the only one who answered my mathematical question correctly, which I finally figured out.
Oh,
he's 27, and he worked for 30 years. This is 1957.
You finally caught up with it, huh? Kitty, your vote was for?
Number one.
And why, Kitty?
He just looked like the most secret of all three Secret Service men.
Hi?
I voted for number one, too, for this reason. Two reasons. First of all, I noticed he was wearing a double-breasted suit, which means it's easy to conceal a Colt 38. And secondly, he knew that Frank Barry was. Frank Barry used to be the chief Secret Service guard for the Truman and Roosevelt administrations.
All right, sir. There we have now our votes and our reasons, showing that our minds are made up. Let's see whether yours have been made up successfully and whether you beat, match, or go beyond the panel. Let's see what happens now, because we're going to find out which one of these gentlemen is the real U.E. Baughman. Will the real U.E. Baughman please stand up?
It doesn't matter. I was right.
All right, there we are. Thank you very much, sir. Now let's find out about the other two gentlemen. Number one, would you tell us who you really are and what you do?
I am George D. Johnson, general manager of the Sheraton McAlpin Hotel here in New York City.
And number three, how about you, sir?
I'm W.F. McLaughlin, manager for Beneficial Finance Company. Come on down and see me.
You didn't hear the end of that when he said he was manager of a finance company. He says, come on down and see me. Yes, hi.
I'd like to know how Mr. Johnson knew Mr. Barry.
I was in Washington in the hotel business at the Sheraton Park in Carlton for the last 25 years.
Uh-huh.
See there? There isn't only columnists that can find these things.
I'd like to check that mathematical thing again. Didn't you say you were 22 when you started?
Well, you worry with him after the show, Ralph. We haven't got too much time now. So after telling everyone there were exactly three incorrect votes for a total of $750 from Geritol, congratulations, gentlemen. I hope you had fun. We did. Good night and good luck to you.